appreciate you guys opening. Thank you. So today we're going to be doing play adaptations. And so the first thing I want you guys to do is take out a piece of notebook paper and a pencil. And that's pretty much all you guys are going to do today besides later. So you guys will just take out a piece of notebook paper and a pencil. Things that you guys see around your house, around your school, something you saw on National Geographic Channel. About 15 more seconds. Of anything that comes to you guys' mind. Okay. So, can somebody give me a couple of, that you guys wrote down?
Tulips.
Holding you. Black shirt in the front corner?
I put a birch tree.
Birch tree?
Yeah.
Okay.
Birch shirt.
Asian pitcher plant?
Asian pitcher plant. I've not heard that one. That's a good one.
A marigold?
Marigold. You have another one?
White oak.
What was that? Willow?
White oak, cheese.
Okay, yes. White oak. So now that we have some of those, for the next part, same kind of thing, but I want you guys to think about how are all of those that we just talked about and what you wrote down different from each other? And so, you know, a white oak tree is not going to look like a Venus flytrap. And so the reason why they don't look the same is because they have different characteristics. And you guys learned a word on a vocab. You guys should have like wrote down the definition on your guys' yellow vocab or spreadsheet. And do you guys remember what it's called when plants have different characteristics that allow them to survive?
Adaptation.
It's perfect. And so for this next part, 30 seconds, can you guys write down as many plant adaptations that you can think of? So things that may help them survive, like example, right on the board up there, long roots or branched roots, tap root. Things like that, like any type of adaptation that you guys can think of. About 10 more seconds. All right. So wrap up the last couple words, and can anybody give me more examples?
Some are carnivorous.
Some are carnivorous. So like Venus flytraps, or in that plant video that you guys watched, you can have go. There was another plant that used tentacles, and it had had sticky things that curled up and wrapped around flies and other insects. So things like that. What's that?
It was interesting.
Yeah, I thought so too. Yeah, it's pretty cool how they move like that.
Those hairs are triggered when you touch it.
The hairs. Any other examples we can see?
Wait,
Colors of the flowers?
Colors of the flowers, yeah. Flower shape, color. The smell of flowers are different. Those are different adaptations. And so those are all things you guys want to keep in mind for today's activity. So before we start, I just want to show you guys a couple pictures of different plants with different adaptations to give you guys kind of an idea of what you guys are going to be doing today. And so this is a type of a grass plant, and you typically see these in the grassland or prairie areas, so maybe you might have seen this in North Dakota. But you see that it has long branching roots to keep the plant anchored with the windy area. And so you have different things like that. And a taproot, if you guys remember from Monday, taproots are a solid one. That is also a different root adaptation that you might have. And this, does anybody know what the name of this plant is? Can you think of that? Any ideas? Or have you seen this before? How many, raise a hand if you have seen this before. Maybe out hunting or hanging out with your friends.
Is this on our pastures?
Yeah, exactly.
My yard.
So this is a thistle, and one of the things, if you
Canadian
can see.
Canadian thistle.
What was that?
Canadian thistle.
Canadian thistle? That's what you think? I don't know for sure.
That's what we call it.
I don't know for sure if it's a Canadian one. I know the actual specific name of it, but I don't know if it's Canadian or not. But one of the things that this does is it has thorns, you can see up there, to help keep animals away from it and makes it not edible. And it also will use wind, the windy areas of the grasslands, to disperse its seeds. Here we have a spiral aloe plant, and we use aloe in lotions and scents and for wound care, stuff like that. And so if you see the way that the plant leaves are designed, it's designed to help shade the plant and keep as much moisture in as possible. So these are things that you would see in a desert area or hot environment. And can everybody just say, do you know what this plant is? Can anybody out loud?
Cactus.
So you guys remember in the video that cactus have fruit that animals eat to disperse their seeds, and then this is also another adaptation that cactuses have. And these are thorns or spines. And you'll see that depending on the cactus type, not all of them are gonna look like this. Some of them are gonna be longer or shorter depending on its needs. So this is a water lily. And the cool thing about water lilies is what enables them to be able to float on top of water is that they actually have tiny ear sacs in the leaves of the flower. And they're also very flexible, so when you see these in the water, they're not going to be turned over, they're not going to be drowning in the water. They're flexible and are able to move with the currents of the water. So this is a coconut. So this is pretty cool. If you guys didn't know how coconuts, or what coconuts were, or how coconut trees grew, the coconut is its seed, and so it uses water to disperse it, type thing. And they will drop their seeds and will float in the water and wash up on shore. And here you can see how it actually will wash up and start. You can see where it starts growing out, and then from there it will start growing roots to anchor it to the ground. And so this is just an example of plant maybe that you'll see, and say this, you might want to use this for one of the biomes today, tropical rainforest. And this is a plant that has a very waxy cuticle on top. And so if you guys can see that the water's pooling and it's not getting absorbed into the leaf, and it's collecting kind of at the tip there. And these are actually called drip tips, so that the water can collect at the bottom, and the plant or tree, whichever, will be able to kind of pass the water down and have it drip down to the bottom there. And so you guys just want to keep some of the things we talked about earlier and like some of those in mind for designing a plant with adaptations to live in an environment. And so I will be giving you guys one of four different biomes. And so we have desert, lake, or pond, prairie grassland, or tropical rainforest. And so you guys are gonna get one of those, and then you have to think about the ways that plants have different adaptations based on where they live and the conditions of where they live. So you have to think about what animals live there, how hot it is there, what type of soil do they have, those type of things. And so you just gotta keep those in mind when you're designing your plant. And so in your drawing, you have to have at least three adaptations, and make sure that whatever adaptation you include, it just needs to fit your environment and how it can serve and to help it best survive. And so you guys can get as creative as you like, or it could be as realistic as you like. We had earlier examples, just to give you guys one. There was a plant that gave off like poisonous gas, or there was another one. This was a little bit more creative, but another group had a sushi on their plant, and they peeled away the sushi. The sushi was the bark, and so they peeled it away, and that was a food source for the animals in that environment. So I thought that was pretty neat. So you guys have a little bit of freedom there. And so just want to make sure that you guys get, give your guys' plant a name, and then at the end of the activity, we'll all be presenting, and it'll only take 20 to 30 seconds per group, so it won't take very long for that. And on the back of your guys' drawing, I want you guys to be able to describe what plant adaptation that you guys have included and why that adaptation helps you guys' plant survive. So that's what you're going to be answering during the presentation. So it doesn't have to be long, just like a quick little description. And so now that we have the directions, I need everybody to find a partner. And if you don't have a partner, then let me know. And I need one partner to grab a blank sheet of paper from the center table, and the other partner can come up and grab a biome for me.
That's a lot of flowers.
I got a great one.
We have to try.